In this episode, we'll walk you through the making of the first sketch of Phase 4. And we say goodbye to my family home. I, like most Doctor Who fans, wanted to do fan films. You know, have your own original Doctor, do this, do that. But I, being very particular, having very high standards for myself and others when it comes to making things, knew deep down I would not make something that would make me happy. I can't help it, I have very high standards. So I found these people online called Time Lord from Hell and the Master Crevice, who made these hilarious spoofs of episodes, and I was like, that's pretty good. And it doesn't require too many people, because you can, in comedy, you can play multiple characters, and it doesn't even matter. And they made this one sketch, I don't know if it's even up anymore, called Doctor Who Big Brother, where a few Doctors are squished into one house.
Hello, camera. I'm Eccleston.
And I'm David! Yeah!
Don't grow up.
And I'm Peter Davison.
And I'm David!
Ha! And I thought, that could be quite funny. And that's how Doctor Who Road started. And so, in July of 2015, I made Doctor Who vs. Moffat. And that became a trilogy, and so on and so forth. I'm sure we will talk more about that as time goes on.
Is this your first time writing a Doctor Who Road sketch?
No, it isn't. I wrote Moffat's Leaving back in, I think it was 2016 or something, 2017. Gosh, that was I mean, there's some good bits in there. Well, some good bits. a lot of it's very dated, very poor humour, but I don't know. It's kind of fun to rewatch on retrospects, obviously. What I was doing and who I was completely different, so obviously that would have affected the writing process, but no, it was kind of fun writing back then. It felt like your YouTube channel wasn't as big a thing as it is now.
Were you excited to write Three Doctors?
When you sent it to me, / Jack sent it to me, or the idea of pitching that to me, the Three Doctors, I immediately assumed he wanted a spoof out of the actual story of the Three Doctors, although I think that his original intention was just to have a sketch which had Three Doctors in it, and playing on the title of the Three Doctors. But no, very excited, because it's one of those stories that, like, I'd never had a really solid plan for how to make it into a sketch, but it came to me as I was writing it. You know, I just found loads of jokes, and because I've watched the story and it's one of those stories that I really like, it's easy to come up with jokes and things like that, and gags. So no, I was very happy with that. And then obviously, since I've written two of the mini sketches, it meant I had a kind of foundation there that I could use for the full sketch.
What's your favourite video you've written for Doctor Who Road?
That's a very good question. I'm actually stuck between all the three recent ones, because I very much enjoy writing all three of them. I mean, being a writer of things, you immediately don't know whether it's any good or not. But in terms of how much I enjoyed it, it'd either be between the Baker one or the Three Doctors. I might have to pick Three Doctors because it's a full-length sketch and there's so many opportunities to write stupid gags in there, and all of them, I sat there laughing to myself the entire time, so I'd probably say the Three Doctors.
Mrs. Moore and Jake, why?
Basically, I put them into the... So I suppose if you go right to start, it's because of the Doctor Who poop Mrs. Moore song, which I absolutely love. I die every time I listen to it. And I always just thought, that as content would be very good to put in a sketch, and I don't know why it's not being put in a sketch. So I thought, well, I'll be the one to do it. So I wrote the Fourth Doctor one with the intent of putting that in somewhere. And then, you know, it kind of made itself, you know, it's using the context of Doctor Who, well, it's in the parallel universe, I'm making a parallel universe in the sketches, that kind of thing, I suppose that was my intent. And then with every sketch, you know, it's like, I thought, well, I haven't actually fully explained it, might as well keep explaining it, and then in Three Doctors it all came to a conclusion.
Advertise yourself, pussy!
I do YouTube, I do Minecraft Doctor Machinimas on my YouTube channel. which I've been doing for quite a few years now, so I like to think I'm pretty good at it. If not, that's a shame, because I thought I was. Feel free to check it out if you're into Doctor Who and Minecraft, or both. And yeah, thank you, Jack, for sending these over. Hope they're good enough for you. Goodbye.
I have lived in this house for nearly 20 years now. I've been in it since I was 2, and I am now 21. it's been a long time, and I love this house. It's big, it's spacious, it's got lots of different rooms. Perfect for filming, as I would later find out. It has served me well, living with my mother and father. I've seen my older brother and older sister move out to different places, and it just seemed... The time seemed right for me to do the same with my lovely girlfriend Gemma, which you would have seen in a couple of videos here and there. I love her to pieces, I've dated her for over a year now. And yeah, so we thought, why not? This happened to coincide with the beginning of Phase 4. It's either fate or convenience, really. And with this, it got me thinking back, and sort of... I'm a very nostalgic person. If you know me at all, you'll know that very well. So, you know, I think back of how all the time I've spent here and all the stories I've told here with Doctor Who Road. I don't know, I get very nostalgic. Not emotional, necessarily. I'm very much a robot in that regard, but yeah. It's, get me sad to say goodbye to this house and you know, the shed. Eccleston's gonna be pissed. One thing I'm not going to miss, the bloody builders that have been working on that bloody thing. I'll turn the camera around, actually. I don't know where life will be at this point when this video goes out, but lockdown is a thing. So I wake up all the time on furlough leave from work to jackhammers and jigsaws and lots of loud construction, because life is cruel about how... construction is timed with life. At this point I'm filming this, unsurprisingly, haven't moved yet, but I'm about a week and a half out. So yeah, very excited to see how it is, because it's not furnished at all. I've got a bunch of my stuff over there already, but it's nowhere near finished. I'm sure I've filmed bits by the time this video comes out that will be in this video. But I figured I'd film a bit whilst I'm still here. For the sake of nostalgia, once again, nostalgia wins my heart and my brain. Okay, the sound quality is going to be rubbish because I'm running around with this microphone wobbling all over the place. But I'm going to quickly show off properly the new gaff. Because to be honest, in the clips I've already filmed for like the sketches that I've done, and especially the Whittaker mini sketch, I've furnished it since then. And when I say I've furnished it, I mean Gemma's furnished it and I've helped. So, right here is the door. All good places have them. Keypot, shoe cupboard. I'm sure you can guess what's in there. Lots of pictures. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Bedroom. Excuse the boxes we just made. Bedside tables. Only took us over a month. TV. There's a window over there, if you can believe that. Through there is a toilet. You don't need to see that. Through this one is also a toilet, if you can believe that. Wow, here's a cupboard. That's another cupboard. Really nothing of value, but then we come through here, and look at that. It's a kitchen. Look, the lights finally work. In the next couple of sketches they don't, but the lights work now. Look at the kitchen, and there's a Gemma! She comes with the place. Here's that. Here's this. All good places need a weapon bucket next to the bin. There's a big TV with a Nintendo Switch and PS4, and there's some little picture in the window. Thankfully you can't see out of this script on the floor and a computer. That's the place. But I suppose that leaves me with just one thing left to do, and this is going to seem daft and stupid to some, but again, it's been 20 years. 20 years in this one location, you feel some sort of an attachment to it. It's a big change for me. So, there's only one thing to do. Next time on Doctor Who Road Confidential, I promise to be actually more in-depth about making the sketch, because this sketch was really bloody easy to make in comparison to the other sketches. Get ready for the musician.